Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will bring to you the current affairs of 27th of December. So let's start the video. But before that, I would like to discuss some of the questions from the second shift of the Bihar sub-inspector exam. They may be important for you also. The first question is, the Turing Award is related to which field? Turing Award. There is a newspaper called Rashd Goftar, which means truth teller. This newspaper was related to the reforms concerning which of the following religions? Rashd Goftar during freedom struggle. United Kingdom has issued new black hole coin to honor which great scientist? Which great scientist was honored by United Kingdom? They issued a new black coin to honor him. Black hole coin. Mara Yur got the GI tag. What is Mara Yur? What is Mara Yur? World Earth Day is celebrated on which date? World Earth Day is celebrated on which date? Which of the following statements is correct about the BrahMos missile? It's a two-stage missile. The missile has flight range of up to 290 km. It can travel at supersonic speed. It operates on the basis of fire and forget system. Fire and forget. Which of the following four statements is true? Intensified mission Indradhanush is related to which of the following sectors? Intensified mission Indradhanush. Who won the 66th Senior Men's National Kabaddi Championship? Men's National Kabaddi Championship was won by which team? Then, what is Wood's dispatch related to? Sir Charles Wood's dispatch. What is it related to? Then, Operation Samudra Maitri. Operation Samudra Maitri was launched by India to help which country? Khamsin. Khamsin is a local wind of which country? Khamsin. Which of the following was not a contribution of Lord Curzon? Police reforms, Bengal partition, army and judicial reforms, or sati abolition? Which was not the reform or not a contribution of Lord Curzon out of these? In September, who was appointed as the new governor of Rajasthan? This question is also important. Hind Swaraj is a book written by which great Indian? Which of the following of these is not an example of analogous organs? You must have heard about it. There are two types of organs in science. There are two types of organs, the analogous organ and the homologous organ. The Olympic Games of 2020 are going to be hosted by which country? The olive ridley turtle is also known as what? Olive ridley turtle. Then this is also good. Which of the following non-metal is liquid at room temperature? Liquid at room temperature. So these are the questions. Now let me tell you the answer. The Turing Award is related to the field of computer science. The exceptional achievers in the field of computer, they are given this Turing Award. Rashd Goftar was a newspaper which was started during the freedom struggle and it was for the Parsis. This newspaper was started by Dada Bhai Naroji, the great freedom fighter. Dada Bhai Naroji to have the reforms within the Parsi community, who have always been a very affluent community. UK has issued black hole coin to honor Stephen Hawking. Stephen Hawking. Mara Yur is a jaggery. It's a good jaggery. World Earth Day is 22nd of April every year. 22nd April. All the four statements about BrahMos are true. It has a two-stage propulsion system. Both the solid propellant and the liquid propellant are used. Solid in the first phase and liquid in the second phase. It can travel at supersonic speed. This is true. And the range it can achieve is 290 km. This is also true. And it operates on the fire and forget system. This is also true. Now, BrahMos was made with the help of Russia. It is Bra plus Mos. So, Mos stands for Moskva, river of Russia, and Bra stands for Brahmaputra, river of India. Intensified mission Indradhanush is for vaccination. Now, there are 8 diseases which are in mission Indradhanush. 66 Senior Men's National Kabaddi Championship was won by Railways. Indian Railways. Charles Wood's dispatch is regarding education reforms in India. Education reform. Then Operation Samudra Maitri is with Indonesia. You know, the, on the island of Sulawesi in Indonesia, there was a tsunami. Then Khamsin is a wind in Egypt. There are a lot of hot winds and cold winds. Cold winds like Mistral and Blizzard. And hot winds are like Sirocco and Harmattan, Khamsin, all of these. Then moving on. Hind Swaraj was a book. It was written by Mahatma Gandhi. And in English, we call it the Home Rule. And this book was banned by the British. Lord Curzon, he was not associated with the Sati abolition. Sati was abolished by Lord William Bentinck. And Raja Ram Mohan Roy, through his Brahmo Samaj, he was able to convince the British about this barbaric practice. Sati was abolished by Lord William Bentinck. Then, new governor of Rajasthan is Kalraj Mishra. Bandaru Dattatreya is Himachal Pradesh. Tamilisai Soundararajan Telangana. Arif Muhammad Khan is Kerala. There are two types of organ. Homologous organs are those which look similar, but their function is completely different. And analogous organs are those which may look different, but their function is same. So, for example, wings of the birds. Now, they may look different, but all of them have one purpose, which is to fly. All the wings, irrespective of which bird it is. So therefore, wings of a bat, wings of a bird, wings of an insect, they all are meant to fly. Hands of a monkey are different. Hands, which are called the forelimbs, they are different. And hands in different animals, they serve different purpose. Some use hands for hunting, some use hands for day-to-day activities, some use it for protection, etc. The Olympic Games of 2020 will take place in Tokyo, that is in Japan. Olive Ridley sea turtle, which you will find at two places in Odisha. One is the Rushikulya Beach. Rushikulya Beach you will find there, and you will also find it in Gahirmat Beach. Now it is a wildlife sanctuary, Gahirmat Wildlife Sanctuary. Non-metal, that is liquid at room temperature, is bromine. So that was it. Now let me come to the current affairs of today. When is the Good Governance Day observed in India? Sushasan Divas. It is observed on 25th of December. It is the birthday of Atal Bihari Vajpayee. It is also the birthday of Madan Mohan Malviya, who was the founder of the Banaras Hindu University. And it is also the Christmas Day. Also remember, recently there was a statue of Atal Bihari Vajpayee that was inaugurated in Lucknow. And can you tell me, write down in comments, which tunnel is named after Atal Bihari Vajpayee now? Which tunnel? Which district of Telangana has won the UNICEF 2019 award for effective implementation of Swachh Bharat mission? Which district of Telangana we are talking about? We are talking about Kamareddy. So Kamareddy district of Telangana has won the UNICEF award for 2019 for effective implementation of Clean India mission or Swachh Bharat. Regarding Telangana, I'll tell you some important points. The government of Telangana, they declared 2020 as the year of artificial intelligence. In Telangana, you will find two tiger reserves. One is Amrabad Tiger Reserve and the second is the Kaval Tiger Reserve. Amrabad and Kaval. You will also find Murugavani National Park. Kasu Brahmanand Reddy National Park is also there. And Mahavir Harina Vanasthali National Park. Then Raitu Mitra is a mobile app that was launched by Telangana. Also remember, Raitu Bandhu is also the scheme of Telangana. And don't confuse it with Raitu Bharosa, because Raitu Bharosa is a scheme of Andhra. First food park of Telangana was opened in Nizamabad. United Nations Development Programme, they gave Equator Prize 2019 to Deccan Development Society. It is based in Medak district of Telangana. Telangana launched something known as Digital Exchange of Telangana, which is called DEET. It's for generating employment for the youth in Telangana. Triple IT Hyderabad launched India Brain Atlas. Indian Institute of Information Technology, Triple IT Hyderabad launched Indian Brain Atlas. And Hyderabad was declared as the UNESCO Creative City of Gastronomy for immaculate culinary skills and food. And Hyderabad, recently two institutes have opened up, which are very, very important. One is the National Research Institute of Unani Medicine for Skin Disorder. And the second one is Indian Railways Institute of Financial Management. Who has taken over as the new president of the Associated Chambers of Commerce and Industry of India, ASOCHAM? Who is the new president? It is Niranjan Hiranandani. Niranjan Hiranandani is the new president of ASOCHAM. Which state has topped the Good Governance Index among the big states? In the Good Governance Index, Tamil Nadu is the best state. Tamil Nadu. It has best governance in India among big states. Remember, Tamil Nadu also received the maximum foreign tourist last year. Maximum foreign tourists were received by Tamil Nadu. This also you need to remember. Then, in the big state, the worst governance is in Jharkhand. Among the northeast and the hilly states of India, best governance is in Himachal Pradesh and worst is in Arunachal Pradesh. Among union territories, the best governance is in Pondicherry and the second one, the last is Lakshadweep. Lakshadweep has the worst governance. So you need to remember all of these because this governance index is by the government of India itself. Which tennis player has decided to retire from tennis in 2020? It is Leander Paes. Finally, Leander Paes is retiring after like 30 years of career, you know. And Leander Paes, he won bronze medal in the 1996 Atlanta Olympics. And this was a great effort because after 1952, that is after 44 years, India won an individual medal at the Olympics. Leander Paes in Atlanta Olympics won the bronze medal. Vernon Philander, who has announced his retirement from all forms of cricket, played for which country? Vernon Philander used to play for South Africa. He was a South African cricket player. South Africa new coach is Mark Boucher. Mark Boucher. Martin Peters passed away recently. He was a renowned what? Martin Peters was a renowned football player. Football player, and he used to play for England. In fact, he scored one of the goals in the 1966 World Cup final that England won, beating West Germany. So he was a legendary player. 1966 World Cup was won by England. India's first long-distance CNG bus was unveiled in which city? India's first long-distance CNG bus was unveiled recently in the capital, New Delhi. New Delhi, it was launched by Petrol and Gas Minister Dharmender Pradhan. Dharmender Pradhan. Ganga Prasad Vimal passed away. He was a renowned what? He was a renowned author. He was a Hindi language author. Another Hindi language author that you should remember is Naseera Sharma. And she won the Vyas Samman for 2019 for her book called Kagaz Ki Nao, which means paper boat. Kagaz Ki Nao. Which state has released a comprehensive database on bulls called Sire Directory? Basically, they want the cows to find a suitable partner. So that bull database has been made and it is the first time that any state in India has made a database of the bull so that the cows can find a suitable bull for them. It has been done by the government of Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh, Kamal Nath is the chief minister. Where is ASI protected monument called Chokhandi Stupa that was in news recently? Chokhandi Stupa was in news also because it has been declared as a monument of national importance, right? And recently there have been signboards here that have been put in Chinese language. Chinese language. And even in Kushinagar, even in Shravasti, Piparvaha, Mahaparinirvan Temple, at lot of places, the signboards have been put in Chinese language. So, Chokhandi Stupa is a Buddhist stupa in Sarnath. Sarnath near Varanasi. So, the answer is Uttar Pradesh. Now, let me tell you some very important points about Uttar Pradesh. Airtel e-governance platform Swan has been launched for Uttar Pradesh. So, Uttar Pradesh have launched their electronic governance platform called Swan in association with Airtel. Uttar Pradesh also launched Atal Bihari Vajpayee residential schools for the children of laborers. UP Police, they launched a mobile app also called C-Plan to aid in community policing. National Police University is getting opened up in Greater Noida. Then Kanya Sumangal Yojana has been started by UP, where 15,000 rupees is given every family if a girl child is born. Munderwa Sugar Mill was inaugurated recently by the Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath in UP. Governor is Anandiben Patel. UP Police, they launched a Savera initiative to make available the senior citizens all the services at their doorstep. E-Ganna, E-Sugarcane or E-Ganna mobile app was launched by UP to eliminate middlemen. National Institute of Unani Medicine will be opened in Ghaziabad. And remember, National Research Institute for Unani Medicine for Skin Disorder will be opened in Hyderabad. 2G ethanol plant will be set up in Gorakhpur. It was announced recently. And Itawa Lion Safari has started in UP. Itawa Lion Safari. Also remember, Ludhiana Tiger Safari has started in Punjab. Vulture Conservation Center recently has been opened in Maharaj Ganj. Naugad Railway Station in UP is now Siddharth Nagar Railway Station. It has been renamed. And National Award for Excellence. National Award for Excellence in Rehabilitation of Person with Disabilities has been given to the UP government. State-owned power giant NTPC is planning to add how much gigawatt of solar power by 2022? NTPC has set a target of 10 gigawatt of solar power by 2022. 10 gigawatt. India's target of renewable energy is 175 gigawatt by 2022. Out of 175 gigawatt, 100 gigawatt is the solar power. And out of 100, 10 gigawatt is the target of NTPC, National Thermal Power Corporation of India. India's first university for transgender community will be opened in which of the following states? Again, it will come up in Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh and where? In Kushinagar district. In Kushinagar district. Kushinagar is the place where Lord Buddha, he left the body form. So, Kushinagar in UP. It is a first of a kind university where transgender will be able to get education. Which country has decided to import polio markers from India recently? Polio marker is nothing but polio medicines. And because there is a shortage of polio medicines in this country, it is Pakistan. So Pakistan will buy polio medicines from India. Shaheed Uddham Singh birth anniversary was celebrated in India on 26th of December 2019. So which birth anniversary? Shaheed Uddham Singh, it was his 120th birth anniversary. He was born in Punjab in Sangrur district. And he belonged to which party? Gadar party. Gadar party. And he assassinated General Dyer, who was responsible for killing of people in Jallianwala Bagh massacre. So he was a great freedom fighter. When was the Foundation Day of Intelligence Bureau observed? Intelligence Bureau Foundation Day was observed on 23rd of December. It works under the Ministry of Home Affairs. And right now, Arvind Kumar is the Director General of Intelligence Bureau. Similarly, there is another organization called RAW. Samant Goyal is the Director General of RAW, Research and Analysis Wing. Remember, IB was created in 1887. So it's a very old organization. Which of the following boards has launched Vidyadan 2? Vidyadan is nothing but giving of education to someone. So educating someone is called Vidyadan. Vidyadan 2, version 2, to provide quality e-content to students and teachers. Vidyadan has been launched by Central Board of Secondary Education, CBSE. Who is the author of the book Shridevi, the Eternal Screen Goddess? This book has been written by Satyarth Nayak. Satyarth Nayak. Who has been declared as the most famous teenager in decades by United Nations? It is Malala Yousafzai, not Greta Thunberg. It is Malala Yousafzai. She is from Pakistan. She is a Nobel Peace Prize winner. Greta Thunberg is from Sweden, and she is a she wrote a book called "Nobody is Too Small to Make a Difference," and she won the International Children's Peace Prize. Which state has increased the retirement age from 58 to 60 for all the Government Transport Corporation employees? Who has done it? It is Telangana. Telangana has increased. Chief Minister is KCR Rao, K. Chandrasekhar Rao. That was the video. I'll see you very soon in the video 28th of December. Thank you for watching StudyIQ Premium.